In this video, we are going to see how to work on Octave Online. Octave Online is a cloud IDE compatible with MATLAB. So, in order to work with cloud IDE, you have to log in first. So, first let us see how to log into Octave Online. Go to Google search, type Octave Online, and when you search, in the first line, it will display Octave Online Cloud IDE compatible with MATLAB. Just click it to open Octave Online. So this will open you with the Octave Online. In the Octave Online, on the right hand side, you can see the menu. Click the menu. It will display all the means of signing in. Just choose the first option, sign in with Google. Give your college mail ID in order to sign in. You got signed in and your mail ID will be displayed here. And this is the Octave Online IDE. In the left panel, leftmost end, it will display all the file names that is available, files created and uploaded. And after that, in the left hand side, you have the script editor. And on the right hand side, you have the command window where the command prompt will be lying below the command window. This is how the Octave Online window will be looking like. Next we'll see the steps to type the commands. So in order to type the commands in Octave command prompt, just go to that Octave command prompt, type your command and then press enter. You can see the output in the command window. For example, here I have typed A equal to 5. And when I press enter, it has been displayed in the command window. Then I have typed B equal to 3. And when I press enter, it has been displayed in the command window. Then in the prompt, I have typed C equal to A plus B. It has added the value of A and B. And the sum has been displayed in the command window. This is how you have to work with the command window. Next, let us see how to work with script file. So, in order to work with script file, first you have to create a new script file. So, to create a new script file, click the new button near the files in the leftmost pan. When you click the new script file, it will open a dialog box. In the dialog box, you have to give the file name. And then you have to click OK. So for example, here I have given my file name my_sum.m. So all the files should have the extension .m. And then click OK. So it will create your script file, new script file. Now in the editor you can type all the commands. And you can see the file name above the editor, in the top of the editor. And after typing the command, click the save button in the toolbox and then click the run option on the right top end of the script editor. So when you click the run button, the code gets executed, and if there is a need to give the input, it will ask for the input in the command prompt. So you can go to the command prompt and see what input you would like to give. So for example, in this program, it asks for the first number and then the second number. So you have to give the two values in the command prompt. After getting the input, and it will display the output here in the command window. So for example, this program, first I would like to get a number and I would like to assign it to A. So for that, input is the function that will be used. So input function is used to get an input. It takes the string to be displayed as the argument. So it will ask for the first number and it will be assigned to A. Then again, I would like to get another input. It will ask for the second number. It will be assigned to B. Disp or display is the function to display any value in a variable. So now I would like to display the value available in A. So I'm using disp of A. It will display the value of A. See here, in this example, the value of A has been displayed. Next, I would like to display the value of B. So the value of B has been displayed. Then I would like to find the sum of two numbers by using C equal to A plus B. So it has found the sum of two numbers. The answer is available in C now. Now I am displaying the sum is, and then I would like to display the value of C. It has been displayed. Next, we'll see how to work with images. In order to work with images, first you have to upload the image files and then only you can start working with the images. So first let us see how to upload the image file. So in order to upload the image file, go to the left pan. First you have the upload file option. Click that. It will help you to open the open dialog box. Now select your image file and click open. Now that your image gets uploaded. So now see in the left pan, you can see the file name of your image file. So rose.jpg is displayed here. Now you can start writing your code. So for example, in the code editor, I've started writing. I would like to read an image file and I would like to display it. So type the code, save the program and then click run. So when you run the program, the image gets loaded and it will be displayed in the command window, output window. So for example, here in this program, I have read an image. So imread is the function that is used to read an image. So it's an argument you have to give the image file name. And it should be given within single quotes. Always use semicolon, which is the line separator. And then the image that has been read is assigned to the variable I. Now I will be referring to your image. Now in order to display your image, just use imshow function. Imshow function is used to display the image. So this is displaying the image in the output window. Next, we'll see how to work with multiple images. First, upload all the images that you would like to display using the same upload button. Next, type the code in the code editor. Save your script. Run the code by clicking the run option. So here see, both the images, I would like to display two images. Both the images are being displayed in the output window. So the program to display multiple images. First, I'm reading the first image, rose.jpg, and I'm assigning it to I. If I directly show the image, imshow, and then if I read the next image and if I show the image, say, what happens? Over the first image, the second image will be displayed. So only Lily will be visible to me, Rose will not be visible to me. So to overcome this problem, we have the figure function. So after reading the first image, I'm showing that this is a separate image. So in order to show that separate, in order to display the image separately in a separate figure window, we'll be using figure function. Figure of 1 will display Rose in a separate window and figure of 2 will display Lily in a separate window. So here, when I execute, first Rose will be displayed and then Lily will be loaded as a separate images. Even I can work with if. When I execute, I would like to ask whether I would like to display Rose or Lily. So I am getting option from the user. So I am using input function to get the option from the user. Now I am checking if the option is 1. If the option is 1, I will be reading Rose image and I'll be displaying. Else, if the option is other than 1, then Lily will be read and it will be displayed. This is how you can work with multiple images with if. Thank you.